Abracadabra.
Expel your armor, Salty&Cyanotic. Have that all. Shall we finish your little son that says Treadwell?
Come bring ya!
Tomorrow's Hunter's first day on his meds. Sure, which one? Kelsey was just telling me. So she said he might be snacky when he gets home. I did. Found a suit of armor.
Can you wear it?
I don't know.
Thank you.
seen better days.
I heard that.
One of Ranrock's camps. Exactly as Madame Beaumont described.
Throw me in some.
Enjoy suffering, do ya? Wizard kind will submit to us, but no more.
Yeah.
See if there's something you need.
What seems to be the problem?
You may well ask. I'm convinced I saw a grim. An omen of death.
not safe. But if it can't see me, I'll be all right, won't I? All I need is an invisibility potion. Yes, that's what I need. I'm afraid I'm all out of invisibility potion. I suggest finding somewhere safe and being especially careful. Safe? Careful? Yes, that makes sense. And you're sure you don't... No. Very well. Hopefully the Grim, or whatever it has foretold, doesn't get me first. Let's see what's up your sleeve this time, Merlin.
Charlie sleeps so hard when he's out. You ever notice that? What is it about being out here, you think? No pibbles?
I mean, let's be honest, he sleeps hard in the house, too.
That's true. He is such an old man. I wish I could sleep that hard.
I was able to clear out Ranrock's camps. You cleared them out? How? It was harrowing, and they dug in their heels, but I managed. When my brother returns, this news will mean the world to him. You saved our hamlet, my young friend. This will not be forgotten. I fear for other hamlets, truly. Ryan Rock and his lot are unlike any goblins I've ever seen. What do you have for sale? What are you looking for exactly? Thank you. Sincerely. Oh, you like that? A fine choice.
Oh, you do. It's fine. Did you,
Thank you for passing through.
Screaming?
Yeah.
Looks intriguing.
You're a little sub that same trip, though.
Almost there.
Jeez. What spells to be doing?
That failed.
Winder. They're like the pre-Voldemort Death Eaters. Charles. My God.
Did he have it?
Oh, yeah.
We have here.
So mocking.
It is a little bit, isn't it?
Yeah.
figured, I found out why there's no, Quidditch in this game.
Why?
Because that's a separate game.
Oh. Interesting. So they didn't include it in this game because they're gonna make a whole separate game for it. Kind of cool, but still kind of sucks at the same time.
Why? Do you have to buy another one?
Well, it would have been nice to have it in this game. Just saying.
I'm ready.
Good. There's no time to lose.
What precisely is the relic I'm to retrieve?
A valuable heirloom known as the Helmet of Erdgott. The witch considered herself a collector and purchased the helmet as a trinket. She cared not what pain she caused the goblins. Goblins believe that the rightful owner of any object is its maker, not its purchaser.
Wizard kind sees things differently. It's a wonder goblins and wizards have ever been able to work together.
The differences between our kinds are myriad.
They seem to be.
It may surprise you to know that I do not believe those differences always to be insurmountable. It is the reason I find myself traveling with you to this tomb today.
Character I'm playing is a real beefsteak, man.
A real what?
Beefsteak.
It's like that, huh?
Yeah, he's a tauren.
Mm.
Literally a giant friggin' bull. I didn't even call him fatty earlier. He didn't mind.
Ah, and there it is. The witch's tomb.
Oh, dreadful looking place, isn't it?
Oh, I found this place earlier. I didn't know what it was.
It's the witch's tomb.
Apparently. silly
that's,
me.
That's the guy we don't trust, isn't it?
No.
Professor, Williams or whatever it is?
I wish you luck.
No, this is different,
well,
guy.
As a one carrier, you should have an advantage. Now, before you set off, do you have any questions?
It all seems clear to me now that we're here.
I do hope our alliance proves fruitful. Again, I wish you luck.
It's a goblin.
I will remain here, eagerly awaiting your return. Please, be careful.
Remember what happened to the last goblin I said I didn't trust?
This is true, he got yeeted.
He did get yeeted.
But do you trust any goblins?
Nope. Every time I see him, all I can think of is somebody going, this seat's taken. He's going to keep a dragon at the very end of a very long underground roller coaster.
Lumos.
I'm all about dragon rights. And dragon lifts.
You going in?
Go.
You're leaving me.
That's bad.
I'm smoking. I'll be back. Don't worry about that.
But I'm lonely. I'll miss you.
Oh, that's too bad. Play your game. Talk to Mr. McWigginface or whatever his fucking name is.
have a feeling I'm not alone here.
I missed a chest. Sometimes we just gotta find the right spot.
Somehow, it looks like it could be rotated. Lumos. What's that hanging there? Looks precarious. Down I go. No other way. It's sealed shut from the other side.
What'd you say?
I just called my little hatchling. Come on. We got shit to do. You can't just be hanging out. You gotta put in the work or you need to get out.
Closer, but how?
Hey, you got me over here feeding some little dinosaur.
Perhaps that kid would help.
You're feeding a dinosaur?
Yeah, got a little hatchling. It said somebody needs to take care of it, and guess who? They got feeding this stupid little thing.
Now you got a stupid ass little baby dinosaur?
Yeah.
I mean, don't we have like 7 of them?
They're not necessarily dinosaurs.
They're little baby house hippos?
Say, oh.
they feel like dinosaurs when they're trying to rip your fingers off to get them the snacks. I'm just saying. They got little dinosaur teeth. Little velociraptors. Jump, damn it, jump. Okay, the stupid heifer.
She's just doing her best.
Her best sucks. Come on. You could do better than that. What the fuck?
Making this spin or to raise that platform. That must be it.
Okay, well, like, when you know when your character should have absolutely no issue with jumping on something? But they can't seem to figure it out.
Yeah.
Like, you get caught on the lip of a wall.
Yeah.
It's like 2 inches.
What about it?
That's what my character's doing right now. And it's really pissing me off. Because there ain't no flipping reason I should have to hit this thing more than once. Yes! Because, oh my god! And it's one of those things that, like, it sinks down.
You trip over air.
We're not talking about me right now.
Oh, no. Who are we talking about?
My stupid character!
Oh, gotcha. You're completely innocent.
I need to bring moths to the door.
Yeah, well, maybe you should jump on the ledge to get the fucking moth.
Lewis.
So what does she do? She turns on a fucking light. Lumos.
Well, I mean, we're gonna have a lot of problems here because eventually she's gonna have to do this with a fucking moth. Jump on the stupid ledge, heifer! Why are you so fucking incapable?
She is doing her best.
She is not doing her best.
She is. You're just being super critical.
This is ridiculous. Why? Can you not make it work? Am I doing something wrong? No, you are.
Is that your official stance?
Yes.
Definitely.
You literally... There's no reason this is that fucking hard. Snickering at me.
I was just listening.
I'm like... Jump! Fucking hell!
But what are we trying to do?
Okay. See this stupid thing?
Yeah. So what's jump on the keyboard?
Then you have to jump up on this thing, mm-hmm. And you're supposed to jump on this goddamn ledge.
What's the jump button?
A. So you have to pull the trigger and then hit B at that thing. And then you gotta jump on the goddamn ledge.
What happens if...
You see what I'm talking about?
Yeah, but did you? All right, watch this. Ready?
Talk to you right now.
Hi, guys.
We're gonna get divorced.
We're gonna get divorced? Is that what you said? Why are you gonna get divorced?
Lumos.
You know damn well that's not what I said. Getting a horse.
Okay.
No, what'd you say?
You come over here and do this because you're so funny. Yes.
Oh, shut up. That's why we're getting a divorce.
I want you to find a resting place. Lovegog said the helmet was in her sarcophagus. Dead Ashwiner. To show this to Lovegog. There must be some sort of mechanism for this door. The sarcophagus has been raided. I found no helmet. Only a dead Ashwiner.
Damn! They got here first. We need to get it before Rookwood uses it to further ingratiate himself to Ranrock. I saw one of their campsites not far from here, but I fear you must go in alone. My fighting days are behind me.
He did.
I'll head there now.
Good. There's no time to lose. Get to that helmet before Rookwood does. We will lose our chance at any leverage, no matter how small, with Ranrock. To think those wretched thieves have their hands on such a relic.
Them fiends. Those wretched thieves. Fiends. Sounding a little crazy over there.
I got a dinosaur, I got a dire horn versus a velociraptor.
You should be proud of all the potions you've brewed.
Thank you.
Charlie, you're so handsome.
Huh?
I said, Charlie, you're so handsome. Because he is.
I know parents lie to their kids. Come on.
Ha 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 ha! That's dirty. Maggie, you're beautiful.
The Ashwinders.
A lamb to the pack. You're making a spot in it. I've never seen that.
She wants out. What is it you want, baby girl? Is your daddy ignoring you? I know, he's so rude. That's why us girls gotta stick together. Girl power!
Yeah, that's why.
Come here, sugar pea. Little ween. My little ween, I love you.
This is for Rookwood.
No,
one shall cast my view.
Are you tired? You getting tired?
I wonder if I'm safe to explore in there. I retrieved the helmet from the Ashwinders.
Well done! This is sure to impress Ranrok.
The helmet shines even more brightly than I imagined. The etchings, the contour of the profile. Remarkable.
It looks stunning, Logok. I see why you wanted it back.
You did the thieves a service by recovering it. I know many a goblin who would have killed for it.
Ah, then I'm glad to be rid of it myself.
Thank you. This should earn Ranrok's trust. I will take it to him immediately. It may distract him from his search.
His search?
It is merely an inkling. You have impressed me greatly, friend. I am glad that I trusted you. We shall speak soon. Best to keep our arrangement quiet for now. Many will not believe that our aims might possibly be aligned.
come. Oh, please tell me you have an answer for me about the Rutherford. Hello, Miss Wellesley. Well, what happened? Did you find them? They led me into the forest and revealed a treasure. Oh, how lovely! I'm glad you were rewarded for your efforts. Perhaps one day I'll be able to bring myself to go into the forest.
Probably.
For now, I'm happy simply knowing there's something so lovely to see. Should I dare?
Folks still talk about you taking down that troll in the village circle. You certainly made an impression.
Should I dare?
Let you live. You want to get me? Come up in here and I'll get you. So? Now I'm going to kill you and I'm going to take your eggs. So. There's that. And I'm going to kill your little spider buddy too.
Sounds like an awful lot of killing going on over there. Spider buddies. You're like,
yeah. It's weird. It really is. Because, I mean, the difference in our games.
Perhaps a hybrid.
Like, my guy knows exactly the appropriate way.
I finished the activities you assigned me, Professor Garnet.
Just casting that shade right over the wall, huh? Just like, whoop! Let me just throw that over there. I've been married long enough.
Fertilizing shrubs and butterflies. I didn't realize how long I've been at it until the sun began to set. Well, if there's one thing I love to see more than my plants thriving, it's one of my students doing the same. Now.
Of course, I throw down threats of divorce and you're just like, yeah, I don't believe you. You can't live without me.
Let's see you give it a go. You will want to focus with this spell. Nothing as mortifying as knocking back a colleague when all you wanted to do was move a few parts.
It's like that TikTok. The whole, I want a divorce.
Wonderfully done.
Mm-hmm. So what do you want
to
eat?
If you'd like to practice a bit more, you're welcome to do so here in the greenhouse. Just mind the plants, please.
Like, I feel like that's how that all went down. You're like, mm-hmm. So you want a frozen margarita. Double shots of tequila. I mean, that's what you just did to me. Of course, I don't see a frozen margarita in my hand.
You're a natural.
see how much you believe me.
Oh, I'm in.
Take a while to adjust to being here.
Precisely, and I was remarkably fortunate. In fact, a seventh year took me under her wing during those first days. She remains one of my dearest friends.
How fortunate.
I was indeed. I dare say you'll find that the friends you make here at Hogwarts will last a lifetime. Now, I'd best get to my recent delivery from the Magic Neep. Mr. Teasley promised me quite an assortment of seats this week. Lovely to see you.
What's that?
Herpes.
That it does. It's the gift that keeps on giving. I'll fight you.
Oh, this guy, he's strong. He's strong.
He's strong. Bronchiosaurus. Have to go let the babies out soon. You out here.
What?
What?
Yeah, that's what I said. What?
What?
This is like a home to me.
You were like, I see why you want me out here.
Yeah.
Why? Who's that?
Probably Jack in the trash can.
Oh, it is Monday, isn't it? Try to take you out?
Yeah. She didn't do anything. Well, we're definitely gonna blame you on
it. Hello again, Stephen. Oh, I was hoping to see you again, my young friend. Gladwin Moon, a Hogwarts guest.
Shelly outside?
At your service.
Shelly.
First, please allow me to apologize if I seem to be.
It was colder outside than in here.
When we last met, I'm afraid I had a rather disconcerting encounter. Although I hear your visit to Hogsmeade was even more eventful than mine.
I suppose you could call it eventful. I certainly wasn't expecting a troll attack.
Oh, of course not. From what I understand, the village was lucky you were there. In fact, my recent visit to Hogsmeade is the reason I was hoping to bump into you. I could use your help with something. Do you see that curious statue over there? Watch what happens when that light changes from day to night. Now, if you wouldn't mind humoring me for a moment, see if you can remove them from the statue. Oh, odd little contraptions, aren't they? It seems the statue vanishes once the moon is removed, which, incidentally, can only be done at night. Why don't you hold on to that one for now, and I'll explain more as we walk. Ever since that fateful day in the village, those curious statues have begun appearing about the castle. A fair number have been strewn around Hogsmeade. Someone, it seems, is trying to torment me. You see, that day in Hogsmeade, I turned a corner and came face to face with a boggart, or shapeshifter, which takes the form of whatever scares you most. This one took the form of a demiguise.
A demiguise?
Yes. Terrifying creature that can see the future. Wholly unnerving. I encountered one when I was a lad in Korea. Terrible experience. Those statues are demiguises. The moons, I assume, are an uninspired play. Some jackanapes used a boggart to learn my greatest fear and use it against me. I have my suspicion as to the scoundrel or scoundrels responsible. It is my hope that they will slip up and reveal themselves as the statues disappear. That is why I need your help in removing the statues.
Well,
a couple of reasons, frankly. First, your daring do against those trolls in Hogsmeade has gained you a reputation for fearlessness. Second, as macabre and hideous as a demiguise is, most would find my fear of them unwarranted. You, however, have seen how they affect me. I'm at my wit's end, young friend. I simply can't bring myself to go near them. In fact, I know two statues right here in the faculty tower. Perhaps you could start simply by removing them, I can go about my evening duties.
I'd be glad to help you, Mr. Moon.
Oh, I knew I could count on you. First, you know how to cast a disillusionment charm, correct? You'll want to do that before wandering the tower at night. Next, you'll notice that the door is locked. However will you get in? Alohomora, that's how.
But what about curfew?
Curfew? Ah, tosh. I said you were a bit like me when I was your age.
You okay?
Oh,
yep.
The school was my oyster. And I took advantage of it.
You feel it?
Oh, everyone loved me for it.
Yeah.
Oh, those were the days. Now, you'll find one statue in the prefect's bathroom and the other in the hospital.
Oh. That's my girl.
A little more.
Done! You're in! Remember, use a disillusionment charm so no one claps eyes on you. This is a restricted area of the castle after all.
Jeez.
Right.
Yeah.
What was that?
Maggie?
Valia. You being crazy?
Yeah, a little bit.
Thank you.
I almost got all the house tokens. That I've been trying to get. Just a minute and I'll be in with you.
Is that so?
We're raising a generation of coddled cape flappers that can scarcely tell the difference between aconite and aspirin.